All right, and welcome back to Campus Crossfire tonight. I'm here with Representative Charlie Collins. We're continuing our interview with him. Now, Representative Collins, as we said before, represents parts of Fayetteville, where many University of Arkansas live, and doesn't actually represent the campus, chairs the Revenue and Taxation Committee, as well as works on many other committees throughout the Arkansas House, and is a candidate for Arkansas Lieutenant Governor. Now, we focused a little bit on the House and some of your plans for the fiscal session. Now, let's talk a little bit about your campaign for Lieutenant Governor. Mm-hmm. Now, in a joke, a friend of mine uses this, the dreaded question with all politicians: why do you want to be Lieutenant Governor?
Actually, I think because I have a plan to help turn Arkansas into a good jobs magnet, and we've started moving the ball in the right direction. For example, in the last session, we passed the first income tax rate reduction in our state's history, which is going to save taxpayers $55 million per year. We passed a significant capital gains tax reduction, mm-hmm. which is going to help investors, which is going to encourage people to invest. We passed a comprehensive tax package, which is going to reduce taxes on Arkansans by $140 million per year, starting January 1, 2015, as it's fully phased in. In addition to the $140 million, there's a $20 million tax break for enterprise zones in areas with tough economies in our state. And finally, we passed a grocery sales tax virtual elimination bill, which will reduce the grocery sales tax by $70 million, but only when we've cut spending that's tied to some penalties that the state has been paying since the school decision back in 1989. Okay. That's going to happen in the next 4 years. So all told, this tax reduction package is about $230 million. That's almost 5% of our budget. We're going to reduce the tax burden on our Kansans. We're going to reduce the regulation burden on our Kansans. Mm-hmm. We're going to improve education. We're going to work toward tort reform to help turn our state into a good jobs magnet. And with a statewide platform to build support for these ideas, I'm confident we can do it faster and better. And finally, mm-hmm. I've got some very close relationships with the leadership in both the House and the Senate from my time there, and from being a part of the committee chair group. So I think I'll be a very effective liaison between the executive branch with our next Republican governor and the legislative branch okay. with our Republican leadership to really get these policies enacted and turn our state into a good jobs magnet.
All right, that's, first of all, the grocery sales tax. First of all, I love it when I find out I'm gonna have to pay less taxes on my groceries, because as a college student, and myself and many of them, we eat a lot, as you probably know, with several of them at home. But another big question that a lot of University of Arkansas students have when it comes to the legislature and things like that is tuition. Mm-hmm. Do you do any work with tuition for the University of Arkansas at all, or anything? Because I mean, a lot of students do worry every year about how much our tuition is going to raise.
Yes, tuition is a huge expense for families with kids in college. I have 4 children in college currently, so
wow.
I understand and feel the burdens of tuition. One of the things that we did in Arkansas is we started a scholarship program, and that scholarship program is very accessible to almost all Arkansas high school students as they get ready to graduate. And I would encourage everybody to apply for that scholarship. One of the challenges is it's based on the amount of money that comes into the scholarship program. And you know, in not untypical fashion, there was a little bit of overpromise and underdeliver in the beginning. So the scholarships promised were probably greater than we can afford. But in this last session, we kind of right-sized those scholarships to match the inflow of money. And so if you get started in school, you've got to stay in school, because year one, you get $2,000 a year, in your second year, $3,000, in your third year, $4,000. And in your fourth and final year, you get $5,000 toward your tuition.
And if you're an in-state student, that nearly pays an entire semester's worth of costs.
So you got it.
That's phenomenal to hear. Now, another, keeping along with a little bit of the students and with the Fayetteville area, in Northwest Arkansas, we see a lot of the impact of Walmart, Tyson, J.B. Hunt, things like that. Do you see the role of the businesses in the Northwest Arkansas area expanding in the next couple of years? How can you make any predictions for that?
Yeah, I think one of the things that's working very well for Northwest Arkansas is the fact that we started out with several major employment centers, including the university itself, and then some of those great companies that you just mentioned. And I think those have become anchors, which have really done a lot to attract people, frankly, from all over the country and beyond, to live here in Northwest Arkansas. That helped us bring in and cross-pollinate with lots of skills from other places. Now what we're seeing is, I'm going to call it the filling in of other businesses and also great cultural things. For example, Crystal Bridges just opened up. We had a very fancy hotel just open up in Bentonville. Lots of other hotels and restaurants and businesses of that type. I also see us becoming more and more technology friendly. And we're going to start to attract technology companies.
I read an article a couple of weeks ago about tech startups coming to the area. Do you see that, as you said, with these startup companies, do you see Northwest Arkansas as a ripe growing place for all for the different companies? Because it is, I think the stat is 80 to 90% of startups fail or have a significant setback in their first 2 years of operations. So do you see this as a place where they could possibly recover from those and grow into the, I mean, Walmart was a startup at one point. Tyson was a startup at one point. Do you see that as growing in the future, as a good place for them?
Yes, I do. And Nanomech is an example of a great profile for a business in terms of how it can develop. And while I certainly can't predict that we're going to defy the laws of business success, the key is if 9 out of 10 have some kind of stumble, then we need to start 100 so we get 10 that are very, very strong, and then we need to do everything we can to help as many of those as possible be successful. But when you have success stories like Nanomech and others, what that does is it tells new entrepreneurs, hey, I can be successful there too. The state, the university, the talent pool, all of those opportunities are things that help us start this business and support the business. And there's other entrepreneurs around me who will be a support network for me as well.
All right, now going off a little bit from the political side, the business side, back into the political side, we've only got about 1 minute left with this, but Arkansas is the focal point for the Republican effort to take back the Senate nation, the U.S. Senate. Do you see the amount, and with the governor's race going to be getting a lot of attention as another Republican against, with an open governor's seat coming up, do you see your campaign and other state officer campaigns benefiting from the national focus on Representative Cotton's Senate campaign?
The short answer is yes, I do. First of all, Tom Cotton is a fantastic representative from the 4th District, and he is a fantastic candidate for U.S. Senate. You and I were talking earlier about our military connections, and Representative Cotton served as an Army Ranger. He served in Afghanistan. He served in Iraq. At the same time, he's got a Harvard Law degree, so he's smart as a whip. He's an incredible physical specimen. He's very bright, very committed, and nobody's ever going to outwork Tom Cotton. So he is a fantastic choice for the people of Arkansas for the U.S. Senate. And with all the support that's going to come into the state, both within and from Arkansas, contributors, donors, and supporters, and then on top of that, all of the money from other places, my personal belief is every Republican in the state, every independent in the state, every conservative in the state is going to know to go to the polls to vote for Tom Cotton, and that's going to help the rest of us on the Republican ballot.
All right. Well, thank you, Representative Collins. We really appreciate your time tonight. We are going to come back with more of your debate on the top political issues of the day. Thank you for tuning in, and Representative Collins, thank you so much. We'll be back in just a minute.